particular with heart cells, I think you can feel that they are more alive because they are moving right in front of your eyes, right? It's really bumping and thriving. So without these cells, we could basically not be alive. I am Abiram Olivares. I am a first-year PhD student here at EMBL Barcelona. EMBL Barcelona is a unit that focuses on tissue biology and disease modeling. And tissues are an intermediate level of organization between single cells and organs. There's a very special thing that happens when you put different cells together, and this is that they get organized, they start interacting between each other, and this allows them to generate new functions. So for instance, you can have the cells of your stomach coming together to make possible the process of digestion, or the cells of your brain making possible the process of thinking, which are processes that are not usually possible if the cells are just isolated from each other. And that's what makes tissues very special. I'm interested in the heartbeat and why bigger animals have slower heart rates than smaller animals. So if you look at mouse, for example, the mice heart can beat up to 600 times per minute. So 10 times faster than a human. And then if you look at a huge animal such as the blue whales, you will see that their heart beats at around 4 times per minute. One explanation of this is that when you count the number of heartbeats that an animal produces along its life, you will realize that it's the same amount for all of the animals. So a very small animal that lives for only 2 years will have the same amount of heartbeats as a very big animal that lives for 80 years. This is the incubator, which is a special chamber with a controlled temperature and humidity. And it helps us to keep the cells in an optimal state, which resembles the human body or the body of the animal that we are studying. These are from human-induced pluripotent stem cells. So stem cells are a very specific type of cell that have the capability of generating all of the cells in our bodies. These cells appear very early during the embryonic development of the organisms. And what we do here in the lab is that we replicate those conditions inside the lab, inside the dish, and to get the same type of cells that you would find in the developing organism. Now I'm going to put the cells in the microscope to check their state and to check whether they are beating. And you can already see that these cells are contracting. So these are heart cells, pacemaker cells, and these cells are in charge of coordinating the heartbeat. I think you can even feel that they are more alive because they are moving right in front of your eyes, right? And that really makes you feel closer to the organism. Throughout our lifetime, our heart will contract about 1 billion times through all of your lifespan. And that's the same for a mouse, and that's the same for an elephant, and that's the same for a rhinoceros. We don't really know why that is. It seems to be connected to the metabolic rate, which is a complicated term, but it basically means how we use our energy, how we use the food that we consume, how do we turn it into energy. So bigger animals are more efficient in turning food into energy than smaller animals. To me, it's nice to study these complex behaviors of cells because the same principles that rule how cells come together and interact and make more complex structures will apply to other higher level organizations like ecosystems, for example. So I think at the end, there might be some general theory of how complexity arises. So my main driver is just the curiosity to understand how living systems work.